so much for being here for our end of year concert. We are starting with awards and then moving into the music for the night. And I'm sure there's people that will be trickling in as we move on to the evening. This choir program has grown so much in my now 3 years here at Battle Mountain. And I'm so proud to lead these students and to teach them and to help them grow in lots of ways every day, both musically and as people. I had the students vote on 3 award categories in each class. And so each class will have a best musician, a most improved musician, and a leadership and service award. And leadership and service is hugely important to me as a teacher and leader and servant for my students. And it is, you know, important that I help these students understand its value as well. And I'm very, very pleased with how they voted for each other. So, without further ado, beginning with low voice choir as we go in performance order, the best overall musician voted in low voice choir was Silas Heafy.
And yeah, please come up for each award.
Congratulations. And this is probably my favorite part of the night already. As I tallied up the votes for low voice choir for most improved, there was a 3-way tie, which just speaks so much to the fact that low voice choir did not exist last year. And my first year here, it was just 4 boys. And now there's over a dozen people in it, and it's just grown so much, and so many of them are singing for the first time, truly. And so this is a great reflection of that. So for our 3-way tie, D'Artagnan Applegate, Bear Smith, and Alex Quinteros. And for our Leadership and Service Award for Low Voice Choir goes to a non-traditional lower voice. And I'm very, very proud to give this to Isabel Applegate. Moving on to High Voice Choir, our most outstanding musician, although this was very, very close to a tie, there's several deserving students, is going to be Alejandra Dominguez. And also, there's not many students who almost win a race in the track meet today and then come to here for the concert and win an award here and has a great solo tonight. Most improved musician in high voice choir, another one that I'm extremely proud of how they've grown, especially this semester, Ruby Randall. Another graduating senior, which I'm sad to see go. And for leadership and service for high voice choir, this student only joined a choir last year, and I was going through awards, realized that they won an award last year too. Jenna Kisker. In Altitude, the auditioned choir, I had all the students in Altitude audition for Allstate. They all volunteered, but I wanted them all to, and they all did, and they all stepped up. It's only eligible for juniors and seniors, and this student, I talked to several other choir directors in the front range, earned the highest score that anyone has heard of, like in decades, and he's a junior. So best musician in Altitude, well-deserved, Silas Heafy. Most improved musician in Altitude, Again, most of these students don't have a singing background, and this student only joined choir at all last year, and then altitude this year. And I'm so sad to see them graduate, but well-deserved most improved musician in altitude, Dylan Stepanek. For leadership and service in altitude, it was almost unanimous, and it won't come as any shock to anybody that knows her, Isabel Applegate. And I also have the privilege of giving a Most Outstanding Senior Award for both choir and theater, and it's going to be Isabel. So, 1 second. Oh, you can go away. Isabel, since my very first day here at Battle Mountain, has always been on time, has always given everything she has to others, has always asked what else she can do for her own work, and has always come in for extra practice and leads by example in so many fantastic ways. And so I'm going to say more at the Senior Awards night, but for time's sake, I'm so, so proud of you, Isabel, and thank you for setting a great example. Show of hands, did you scan the program QR code?
No.
Oh, well, you should. I typed all the lyrics to every single song in there, and you can see how many songs there are, and you'll see that there's a 10-minute intermission coming up tonight. And you would also see that that right now is supposed to be the letters portion for students that earned choir letters. And I waited too long taking in the letter paperwork from the students, and the front office told me, give them an IOU. And then I left the list of them back there. So 12 of you got letters. I don't want to rattle off to the top of my head who I remember, because I'm going to forget some of you. If you think that you did and you didn't, or you're not on my list, just talk to me in class, okay? Without further ado, let's listen to some fantastic music. Please welcome Low Voice Choir to the stage. And please, you can scan the QR codes, they're posted around. You can get up, I won't be mad.
Ave Maria.
Oh. gentlemen, the one, the only, Grease Lightning!
as we transition to high voice choirs, next portion of the concert. If you haven't heard, one of the big things we do as music programs is go to performance assessments, or festivals as they're called in this state. And I had the opportunity to take all of these students down to Eaton in the Front Range last week, which was the location of a festival that we were able to fit into our schedules. And I'm so proud of how all these students did. Last year was the first time that I took a group to a festival. It was just Altitude, and they did wonderfully last year. But this year, I took all three choirs. Low voice choir that you just heard earned the second best possible rating that they can get, as did high voice choir, which you're about to hear. And Altitude got the best possible rating of Superior. So I'm so, so proud of the students and the work that they've done. And the concert's titled On Broadway. The first two songs in each set are not Broadway songs. That's because they were the academic songs that we did at the festival. And so we're letting you hear those as well. So just a programming note there. Please enjoy High Voice Choir.
Yeah. that's just gonna have to wait a while. Ain't got time for messing around, and it's not my style. This whole town can slow you down, people taking the easy way. But I know exactly where I'm going, getting closer, closer every day, and I'm almost there.
My queen of the night.
I have many thank yous to make, but it's intermission now. I would be remiss just to not say, of course, thank you to Kyle Jones. The concert will resume at 7:30. Please use the bathroom and scan the QR code to see the program.
Thank you.
As we begin the second half of this concert, you've probably noticed by now that the students are standing on our cafeteria tables. We are trying to purchase risers. They are very expensive. And if you would like to make a donation, please email me or let me know, because we desperately need it. The festival we went to in Eaton last week, that's 3 hours away. It was a very, very long day for us. And Celeste, my coworker, was able to host the instrumental version of that Shasta Festival here. But I can't do that unless we have risers. And so we're desperately trying to fundraise more so that we can actually have risers to perform on. Because these tables do function very well, but they're not the classiest move. So we would love your help in that way. So please let me know if you'd like to contribute. And now please enjoy Altitude.
Thank you.
mother sings a song of purple summer through the heart of everything, and heaven waits so close it seems to show a child the wonders of a world beyond her dreams.
Once upon a time.
In a far off kingdom,
lived a young maiden,
a sad young lad,
and a childless baker.
With his wife,
into the
be misled. I should have heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. And he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my path, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. And he made me feel excited, well, excited and scared.
Save you.
before we move on to the last part of the concert, Mary Poppins, I just want seniors that are still in the other choirs to come up and join us real quick. And if you're a junior still on stage, just go hang out in a wing for me for a second. And seniors, just make a line, like, over here behind Kyle. I didn't tell them I was going to do this, so they're very confused. Yes, go down some that way. It's okay, you can go in front of the drum. Yeah, some more.
Oh no.
This has been an incredible senior class. Those of you that were involved my first year here when you were sophomores, we have come such a long way, and I'm so proud of your hard work. I'm so thankful for all of the laughs. I'm so thankful for you setting an incredible example for all of the underclassmen that are still here to look up to you guys. I'm sure you all remember what it was like to be a freshman and a sophomore, and it was still COVID. And you have come so far with resounding performance after resounding performance, both in choir and in orchestra and in theater for show after show after show. And you have left behind a fantastic legacy. And I will never forget that. It's been amazing. I will miss each of you so dearly, but this is not the end. We still have some great goals to accomplish this last month and a half. So there's more words to be said, but I couldn't let this night go without recognizing them, and please help me by recognizing the fantastic job they've done. Thank you. And now, everybody come up for Mary Poppins. Before we get into this final medley, I just need to say thank you to my administrators, Jason Mills, Gentry Nixon, Rob Parrish, and Maxine Cordova, for their continued support of this program and myself as a teacher, and also my fellow teachers in the building. We are a fantastic team at Battle Mountain. I'm so grateful to be a part of it, but none more so am I grateful for than Celeste Landy, my counterpart in the music department. We have been through a lot these last 3 years, and I'm so grateful to have you as a coworker, Celeste. Another huge thank you to Solveig Bloomquist, who did a last-minute lighting design for tonight's concert. And I already said thank you to Kyle. And last but not least, all of you parents. You have raised some fantastic children, and it makes my job way easier. So thank you, because it's my privilege and pleasure to teach your children. I hope you enjoy this Mary Poppins medley.
Thank you. Smiling out. super, cali, fragilistic, expialidocious. In trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Thank you all. Thank you all for being here. Please tell your friends. They missed out. All right? And also, they can watch on the High Five Access Media anytime. It's online. Ask them for the link or scan the program QR code. It has the link too. Have a great night, everybody. Thank you all so much. Good night.
Thank you.